people come up to me and say, yeah, you're like Gabrielle's Wish, and never heard of you. Good. Never heard of us. So
Gabrielle's Wish were one of those rash of bands that never managed to break out of, like, the first division.
Yeah, I think they're definitely in that tradition of bands like the early Fall, early Joy Division. That tradition of Manchester bands is like it a lump, but this is what it is.
You're better off banking on them than banking off them.
Apart from the City season ticket, you're not going to sell anything to Rob Gretton, really, are you? You know what I mean? Like, Rob's got a pair of ears, and that, you know, I can imagine him having a bit of Damascus moment, similar to the one that he had when he saw Joy Division the first time in the Rafters Battle of the Bands thing. That he said, well, this is mine, you know, I'm having this.
I think that, you know, the word about bands, about being kind of cult status, fits, is made for Gabrielle's Wish.
Gabrielle's Wish, and I don't think they're that dissimilar to Joy Division, certainly Echoes with Joy Division.
Well, actually, when you think about terms of a band like Gabrielle's Wish getting a wider audience, it asks bigger questions about what alternative music itself actually is nowadays.
See Gabrielle's Wish as a classic band that deserves the recognition that the quite virgins deserve.
Yeah, you're getting paid to play drums at the Apollo and see two of your favourite bands. Yeah, it was a good night. That was a good one.
I didn't see him as like stuck in that Manchester bracket that always gets tagged with. You know, they're not a baggy band at all, far more visceral.
Like I said to you before, the Gabrielle's Wish could sell, you know, 5 million copies next year. Probably could sell 5.
Northern? I don't know what that means really. To me, it came from here.
A Mark E. Smith interview a bit ago, he was going on that he has to be so unprofessional. These musicians, he works hard to be unprofessional. And people I've heard say, oh, Gabrielle sound like them, but I think it's the way around, really, for me. Gabrielle, if I'm allowed to swear, shit all over Mark E. Smith.
I think they come out of that kind of space of classic, kind of old school Manchester sound and bands. But they're probably they're the last of that tradition, aren't they? Because they're definitely the youngest of those kind of bands.
And would a band like that ever make it? Because they're a cult band. And I think they have made it. Because they are a cult band, and we're still talking about them now. And they're still a cult band.
Gabrielle's Wish, you know, I wish them, obviously, every success, you know.
Like I said before, to me they're the quintessential Manchester underground band, but who knows, anything's possible, isn't it?
From my point of view, it's always been an outsider's point of view, looking in. And if it stays like that, that's how I like it.
I tried to get in the band myself. But, you know, they won't have me, so I'm too fat.